Hello everyone, this is Dr. Hemi Soneja. I'm a consultant endocrinologist at Max Smart Hospital, Saket. As you all know, we are living in this era where chronic medical problems like diabetes, high blood pressure, obesity, they are increasing day by day. Today I'm going to be particularly talking about high blood pressure or hypertension, as we call it in medical terms. So when somebody is running a blood pressure of more than 140 by 90, at an age of less than 60 years, or if they are running a blood pressure of more than 150 by 90 at an age of more than 60 years, we call it as hypertension. Now, what is the problem with hypertension? The issue comes up is that it's not the blood pressure itself because of which somebody is going to have any symptoms or problems, but it's the complications or the sequelae of that. So problems like having issues with retinopathy, which is sudden effect on the retina, because of which there can be sudden blindness. There can be issues with stroke, which can cause paralysis of one side of the body. Issues with heart attack or myocardial infarction, as we call it in medical terms. So these are significant medical problems which can happen to people because of hypertension. So it's not that one-time blood pressure reading of 160 by 90 is a concern. We don't go by just one time blood pressure reading. We monitor it over a few days for a few successive times and see how your blood pressures are running, and then accordingly diagnose and treat you accordingly for that. High blood pressure is associated with a lot of medical problems, as I already said. It also leads to a lot of deaths worldwide. So what's being seen that on an average, around 40.2 billion deaths were reported in a year recently, in 2017. It is a significant number. And these numbers are increasing day by day. As Indians, we are much more at a risk of having issues with hypertension compared to our European counterparts. There are a lot of factors which add on to issues with that. One is the increasing age. As we keep getting older, there is stiffening of the blood vessels, which adds on to issues with high blood pressure as we get older. That's the reason why the cutoff for older people is higher at 150 by 90. The other thing which happens is the issues with the lifestyle changes, particularly the salt intake in our diet. Salt intake, excessive salt intake has a definite a strong contributory factor towards hypertension. The other thing which is there is a improper diet. High fatty foods, processed foods, these add on to issues with diabetes, these add on to issues with obesity, which further increase our problems with hypertension. Another thing is a lack of exercise, that further adds on to problems. Next is increasing amount of people who are doing smoking these days. So what's been seen is around 25-30% of people are smoking, which increases our risk of high blood pressure to a great extent. And whether it is in form of cigarette smoke or bidi, or it is in form of tobacco chewing, all of these have a significant impact on our blood pressure. And quitting smoking will have a very good effect on the blood pressure very soon. So something to be mindful about. Other thing which adds on to the problems with high blood pressure is the stress, which again is a part and parcel of our urbanized and fast-paced life. But having said that, it doesn't mean that there's nothing we can do about that. We can definitely add on some meditation and yoga to help control that. Other thing which adds on is issues with diabetes and high cholesterol. So people with diabetes are at a much higher risk of having issues with hypertension. People with diabetes, 2 out of 3 of them are seen to have issues with hypertension. So that is another thing to be particular about. So these are the main factors which add on to our problems with hypertension. Now, the next question which comes up is, what can we do to prevent the problem of hypertension, and how can we control that in the long run? The first and foremost thing is to monitor your blood pressures on a regular basis, so that it can be picked up on time. And whether or not it is normal, there are certain changes which we advise anyways. And the other very easy thing to do is to cut down on your processed food intake. So whether it's biscuits, cookies, any of these packaged snack items, they are very high in salt content. So something which we have to be particular about to cut down on. Other thing is to add on more fresh fruits and vegetables. Fresh vegetables, the raw vegetables, they are rich in antioxidants and they decrease inflammation in the body. So very important to add that on. Adding on some regular exercise. So around 30 or 40 minutes of brisk walk a day, 5 days a week will be enough to take care of things. It's not about having to spend 2 hours in the gym on a regular basis to help get the benefits of exercise. This half an hour, 45 minutes of regular exercise will also keep things in check. Another thing which is important is to manage your stress levels with yoga or meditation. All of these things are going to help you a lot in the long run. And when you're working on a combination of these things, along with proper monitoring and seeing your doctor on a regular basis, that is what is going to help you in the long run a lot. We regularly see people who are having issues with high blood pressure, also people who are having issues with diabetes. Diabetes is a modern day epidemic, and what we are seeing is that people with diabetes are at a much higher risk of having issues with high blood pressure also. So around 2 out of 3 people with diabetes have issues with high blood pressure as well. So both these things, they kind of go hand in hand. And that is the reason why we are seeing these problems happening so frequently together. High blood pressure is when somebody is running a blood pressure of more than 140/90 on multiple occasions. We diagnose that as hypertension. If somebody is older than 60 years of age, then we keep the cutoff as 150/90. But in people with diabetes, we would prefer them to have a blood pressure of less than 140/90, irrespective of their age. So it's not just about what other medical problems you have, it is also about what how old you are that we determine what your blood pressure should be. Younger people nowadays also are having issues with high blood pressure. So what essentially happens with diabetes is that because of the increasing blood sugar levels, there is stiffening in the blood vessel walls and there is thickening of that and there's plaque formation on that. And that is the reason why it adds on to issues with high blood pressure readings for them. The combination of diabetes and high blood pressure further on leads to issues with increased problems with heart attack, stroke, in which people can have paralysis of one side of their body. Some people might recover very well from that. Some people might have long-term weakness, and some people might even be bedridden for the rest of their life after that. So having hypertension with diabetes becomes a very serious combination of problems. If they're not handled properly, things can really go out of hands. This combination of problems can also lead on to issues with eye problems like retinopathy, in which people can have issues with sudden blindness also. It can also increase the risk of kidney disease. In fact, diabetes and hypertension, they are one of the leading causes of kidney failure and for people needing dialysis in their life. Now, you know, talking about what are the issues because of which these problems are increasing. Age definitely adds on to that. Smoking, alcohol, these are the other risk factors. Stress levels at home or work are going to add on to that. Your weight, that has significant impact on high blood pressure and diabetes as well. And being overweight increases your risk of high blood pressure by 2 times. Being obese increases your risk of having issues with high blood pressure by around 3 times. And anyways, as I said, people with diabetes are at a much higher risk of having issues with hypertension. Other thing which adds on to these problems is issues with smoking and alcohol, and the poor lifestyle that we are leading nowadays. And these combination of factors increases our risk of hypertension. Now, what all can we do to prevent or control the problem with hypertension when we have issues with diabetes as well? One of the most important things is to cut down on your salt intake. And an easy thing to do is to measure the amount of salt which is being consumed in the house as a family. The next thing is to be particular about our diet in other aspects like increasing the fruit intake, increasing the raw vegetable intake. So these raw vegetables, they're very rich in antioxidants. They help reverse the process of inflammation which is happening in the body because of the excess weight and diabetes, and helps with diabetes reversal and maintaining the weight, and also help with decreasing the weight as well. Without diet changes, your weight is not going to change. So 70-80% of the contribution towards weight loss is with the diet itself. A lot of times people think that maybe adding on some medications is going to help, but medications also are not going to work if our diet is not in place. Other thing to add on is some amount of regular exercise. So around 30 or 40 minutes of brisk walk a day would suffice. And if you're looking at being able to lose weight, around an hour a day of exercise, around 5 days a week, will be enough to take care of things. It's not about having to run marathons or doing heavy weight trainings, which is going to make you see results. Exercise is something that even with 1 week of exercise, you're going to start seeing improvement in your blood sugar levels and improvement in your blood pressures as well. So something to be particular about. So this in addition to this combination of diet and exercise and salt, regulating the salt intake, other important aspect is to take care of the stress levels in the body. And again, you know, small lifestyle modifications like adding on some meditation for a few minutes, adding on yoga in your daily lifestyle is going to help you in the long run with that. This is not something which is going to show you immediate results, but over a long term, this is what is going to help. And next is to cut down on processed foods. They are very high in sugar content, they are very high in processed flour content, which indirectly increases our blood sugar levels and puts us at risk of having issues with increased blood sugars and obesity. So very important to cut down on processed foods. I always tell my patients, not only you that I'm asking to cut down on processed foods, I also don't do processed foods on a regular basis. So something to be particular about. Other thing which is very important is to cutting down on your smoking. So whether it is use of tobacco in form of smoking or whether it's chewing tobacco, both of them have an effect on your blood pressure level. Another thing comes up is alcohol intake. It is very important to keep that in moderation. For people who have had issues with alcohol abuse in the past and they've had issues with alcohol addiction in the past, we don't recommend any amount of alcohol for them in the long run after that. So these are things to be particular about. And in addition to that, it is important to monitor your blood sugar levels and monitor your blood pressure levels as well on a regular basis. So certain things to be mindful about will be your diet, exercise, salt intake, cutting down on smoking and alcohol, and adding on some regular exercise to your daily routine. Thank you so much.